Hi children, welcome to Educa. Today we are with the second part of fifth lesson, light and vision. Our subtopic is light rays and light beams. You may have observed the light filtering through clouds or trees on a foggy morning, or light emitting from headlights of a vehicle on a rainy night. They are known as light beams. Let's do this activity to learn about light beams. We will need a candle, pieces of cardboard, pair of scissors, box of matches, stand, clay, needle and a string. What we have to do: make a holes in a pieces of cardboard as shown in the figure. Then light the candle and fix it. Fix the pieces of cardboard to the stand with clay. You should be able to see the flame through all cardboard pieces. Take the needle with a string and send it through the holes carefully. Fix the string in a straight line and observe the flame through the holes. Change the string and observe the flame again through the holes. When the string is straight line, we can observe the flame, but we change its position, we cannot observe the flame through the holes. Here you are able to observe the flame because the light travels from the flame to the eye through the holes. When the holes are in a straight line, the flame could be observed, and when they are not in a straight line, flame couldn't be seen. Now you can understand that light is transmitted only in the straight line. In this activity, the string which was put through the hole shows the path of the light ray. A narrow path in which light is transmitted known as light ray. To show the light ray, we use a straight line with an arrow. A light beam is made up of collection of light rays. You have seen the light beam which is emitted from the torch when it is switched on. We use several straight lines with arrow heads to show a light beam. Now you can see a light ray and light beam which we are use to show. There are several activities to observe light beams. The first one is this: you need a torch, a white color paper, a comb with a thin teeth. What we have to do: choose a desk kept in the dark place and keep the comb as shown in the figure on the white paper perpendicular to the desk and the teeth directed downwards. Direct the torch towards the comb and light it up. You will be able to see the beam of light emitted by the torch and the light rays which travel through the teeth of the comb. Mark those rays on the white paper with a pencil. You will see that rays drawn by your straight line, they are considered as light rays. Second activity: we need large transparent glass bottle, some joysticks, laser beam torch or torch covered with a black color paper with a hole in the middle, a piece of cardboard. What we have to do: first make the hole in the piece of cardboard and insert the joystick through it. Then light the joysticks. Now, close the top of the bottle with a piece of cardboard. The lighted end of the joysticks should be put inside the bottle. Let the bottle fill with the smoke and direct the laser beam towards the bottle and light it up. Change the direction of torch and observe the differences. You can observe the path in which light transmitted from the torch to the smoke in the bottle. Next one: we need large transparent glass bottle, water, small cake of soap, laser beam, torch or torch covered with a black color paper with has the hole in the middle. What we have to do, take some water and add cake of soap and stir it well until it dissolves in water. Now fill the bottle with the soap solution. Then keep the torch near the bottle and get it light. Direct it towards the bottle. Now change the direction of the torch and observe the changes. You can see the path of the light ray through the bottle of water. In these activities, you can understand that light rays transmit in straight line. Our next subtopic is application of light. Light is the major need for proper vision. With development of technology, we have changed the behavior of light and obtained many uses. Let's see some application of light for production of food in plants, to give a clear vision, to give signals, for communication, in medical field, for entertainment, for illumination. Let's categorize the applications of light one by one. First one, for the production of food in plants. Unlike other living organisms, green plants can produce their own food. The energy needed for the process of food is obtained from the sunlight. You all know that all other animals directly or indirectly depend on the plants for food. Because of this, we consider the production of food is plants is the main advantage of light. To give a clear vision. Earlier, people received light from natural objects such as sun, moon, and stars. But after invention of fire, man was able to produce light from various sources. With the development of technology, the light bulb was invented to get light. Today, there are many types of bulbs in market. You can see different types of bulb in this picture. Next one, illumination. At present, most of countries in the world use different colored and pattern bulbs to illuminate various occasions. Large light sources are used in marketplaces, populated streets, and shopping complexes for advertisements. You must have seen that not only at light at night, but also during the daytime, the lights are kept on as signals. An instance where light is used to give signals is the light used in lighthouses. They release a powerful beam of light which gives the signal to the sailors that the land is close. In traffic lights, you may have seen the colors red, green, and yellow. They individually give message to drivers and pedestrians. More attention is gained through the use of light to give such signals. Red is a color which shows the danger. For communication. Communication in the modern world is well developed. For this, different types of light rays are used. Telephone messages are transmitted through the optic fibers. Telephone connection network across the main cities of Sri Lanka have been built using optic fibers. Optic fibers are used to connect computer networks and high standard audio visual equipment. They use optic fibers and laser rays to send telephone messages and to maintain internet connections. In the medical field, at present, doctors use laser rays to treat eye patients in heart operations and treat wounds in digestive system. This has increased the efficiency of treatments. With the use of optic fibers, the interior part of body are easily observed. Here, the equipment used to lighten the interior of the body is called endoscope. You can see the endoscope here. Next one, for entertainment. In musical shows and fairs, light is used in large scale. They use spotlights of different colors to light up the stage. Even lights are used in toys designed for children. To produce light artificially, we have to spend money. Therefore, unnecessary usage of light is wastage of energy and money. So we must always be cautious enough to stop wastage of light, and at the same time we must use it without making disturbance to others. This is what we have to learn throughout light and vision lesson. Our next video from grade 6 is sound and hearing. Thank you.